Psalms is an amazing book. The reason is very obvious, that we study the places we are at in life, older, younger, in good times, in not good times, and we always come to the same conclusion. God is Lord, and we need to praise His name. Now, God is not egomaniac, that He desires praise to make Himself feel good, but God desires us to reset our minds so we understand who the Lord is. We are so preoccupied with praising things that God says, you need to praise me, the God of heaven and earth, so that we can keep straight our priorities. Very important. Get your Bible guide out and turn to today's passage. If you don't have a Bible guide, of course, why not? Use the addresses at the bottom of the screen and write to us. We'd be happy to send you a Bible guide for an offering in any amount. You can also go to www.BibleDiscoveryTV.com. When you go there, click on donate, make a donation in any amount. Also, I need to tell you something. That'll take you to the PDF files, by the way, the Bible guide. But I need to tell you that we have some amazing blogs there. You know, Jasmine and Rachel Matlock, they write and they study and they look at that. So I want you to keep that in mind. Look at the blogs. They're very interesting. Bible Discovery TV is a great place for you to get a hold of the Word of God and study it. Well, in today's passage, we are looking at something interesting. And this is not something that a lot of people like to talk about, but it's true. Unfortunately, when people talk about it, they make it sort of judgmental. And we don't really understand what that means because God's emotions are perfect. God returns to the earth to judge. Did you know that God did that? That He said, I'm going to return to the earth and I'm going to judge. That's exactly what the Bible says. We're reading Psalms 50 to 54. This is an amazing passage. Keep up through the Bible when you read through it. We're looking at Psalm 50, verses 1 through 11. And as we do, we need to pray. And when we pray, we're going to ask the Lord to teach us His ways and show us His path. When we do that, the Holy Spirit comes in and begins to take over how we hear and how we read the message. Father, I pray today that you would take over our teaching today. Help people to understand you. Help people to see you, Lord. And in Jesus' name, I pray, Father, that I would not get in the way of what your Holy Spirit wants to do. Use me according to how your Holy Spirit has it. Fill me with your Spirit, fill the people with your Spirit, and in Jesus' name, amen. Now, with that in mind, we move to the scripture. Look at Psalms 50. Fascinating. The mighty one, God the Lord, has spoken and called the earth from the rising of the sun to its going down. Out of Zion, the perfection of beauty, God will shine forth. Out of Zion, that's amazing. Verse 3 says, our God shall come and shall not keep silent. A fire shall devour before him.
Really?
Yes. And it shall be very tempestuous all around him. Now, this is amazing because we need to understand that God speaks from Zion. God speaks from Zion, the perfection of beauty. We must look to Israel for what is happening in the world. Now, I've been to Israel several times. Perhaps you've never been to Israel. Well, you know, if you can, you should make opportunity to go sometime, but we can't actually all go to Israel without God returning. And God will return and we will come to Israel as we meet God in the sky. But it's important for us to recognize that Israel, that small nation, in the huge, surrounded by the gigantic nations all around them, Israel's just a small nation. Israel is the place where Zion is the place where God is coming back, where God returns. We need to think that through and understand that in this time, I mean, it was in 1948 that really things began to take off for Israel. So Israel's 70 years old this year. That's amazing. And so we need to consider that God is doing something very real in Israel. Psalm 50 tells us that. Psalm 50, verse 4 continues. It says, he shall call to the heavens from above and to the earth that he may judge his people. His people. Gather my saints together to me, says the Lord, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. A covenant? That's right, a covenant, not a business deal, a covenant. Let the heavens declare his righteousness, for God himself is the judge. You know, I got to tell you something. This is a fascinating passage. God will gather all the saints to himself before he judges the world. Now, he'll judge the saints, but we'll talk about that in a minute. He says we must come to Jesus Christ today. Now listen carefully. When we invite Jesus Christ, and I've said this so many times, I'm going to say it again. We invite Jesus Christ to be Lord of our lives. Lord, what does that mean? It means he's in control. Very important. There are two judgment seats. There's the judgment seat of Jesus Christ and the judgment seat of God. That is the perfection of the world at the end. He judges that. That's in Revelation. But the judgment seat of Christ is interesting. You know, God says, what did you do with what I gave you? So I want to make sure that I can say with all of my heart, I did whatever I could to tell people about Jesus, to do whatever I can to at least read every word in the Bible, to say to Jesus Christ, you know, I read every word. I'm not sure I understood it, but I read it and I tried to read it. So important for me to do that. And I want to encourage you. You should think that through, because I think it's important for every Christian to read the Word of God as God has spoke the 773 plus words to you and to me. Psalm 50 verse 7 says, "Hear, O my people, and I will speak, O Israel. I will testify against you. I am God, your God. I will not rebuke you for your sacrifices or your burnt offerings, which are continually before me. I will not take a bull from your house, nor goats out of your folds. For every beast of the forest is mine, and the cattle on a thousand hills. I know all of the birds of the mountains and the wild beasts of the fields. They are mine." Brings us to this last point. God will deal with Israel once he judges the earth. God will deal with Israel once he judges the earth. Beloved, we must understand that God is not interested in things we do, but he's interested in us, in you and me. May we bring our lives in captivity with God's direction and say, "Lord, you are the Lord of my life. Help me to do things that follow you." This is so important. Psalm 50 is very important today. That's what it tells us.
Think you can read the Bible in 1 year? Click the Bible Guide links and make a donation in any amount. Start your daily devotional today.